Well, hi, everyone. Thank you for coming. And thank you, Skylar, for coming to hang with us.
Yeah, thank you for having me. Thanks, everyone. Yeah.
So you've had a bit of a crazy morning, I think.
Yes, it's been
crazy. So tell us all a little bit about it.
So I just actually came back from performing on the Today Show, which was amazing. I was Elvin Duran's Artist of the Month, which is incredible. And it was so amazing, and I'm so blessed that I got that opportunity, and it was so much fun.
So what was your initial reaction when you heard that Elvis Duran was going to have you on the Today Show with Kathy Lee and Hoda as his Artist of the Month?
Yeah, well, me and my mom were driving in the car on our way back from L.A., and Andrew, my manager, called me, and he was like, guys, I have some news, like, stay calm. And we're like, we're not going to stay calm if it's something exciting. And he told us, and we were, like, freaking out in the car, and it was so amazing, and it was just awesome.
So how long have you been awake for? What time did you have to be there this morning?
Well, this morning I woke up at 4 a.m. I didn't really get any sleep because I was too excited to sleep. I kept getting up and like, oh my God, this is really happening. But yeah, I got up at 4. We had to be there for like sound check at 5. And then usually like the dancers in my band were like waiting in the green room for 3 hours. And I went back to the hotel to do like hair and makeup and have like a vocal lesson so I could warm up. And I performed like an hour and a half ago. So, yeah.
That's so much fun.
Yeah.
So when did you have that kind of aha moment and when you knew you wanted to be an entertainer?
Well, when I was 9, I signed myself up for a school talent show to play the piano. This was like in third grade back in Wisconsin where I used to live. And when I went to audition, they're like, oh no, we don't want you to play piano. We want you to sing. And I was like, what? Like, this is crazy. I do not sing. I don't think I can sing. This is like so embarrassing. I sang for them, found it a week later. They loved it and they wanted me to sing in the talent show and they didn't want me to play piano or anything having to do with piano. And I was so nervous because my parents don't sing. No one we know sings. And then I sang a week later and everyone was just like, oh my gosh, like, why didn't you tell us you could sing? And I was just, I loved it so much. And I just knew that that's what I wanted to do forever.
That's so crazy to me because you're 13 and you have this huge, incredible adult, mature voice.
Thank you.
So, I mean, I was going to ask you, where does that voice come from if no one in your family sings?
We have no idea at all.
That's amazing. So I want to take it back a little bit. And you started by doing covers on YouTube.
Yeah.
So kind of when did you decide that you really wanted to do this and you wanted to start writing original music and, you know, release your EP, which you released independently?
Yeah, well, after the talent show and that happened, we just started doing like local national anthems in Wisconsin. And by like 6 months, like I've done everything in the Wisconsin, Chicago, like area. And I was like, Mom, like there's nothing else for me to do. And finally I convinced her to move out to California. And, you know, I had still did more continuous national anthems. And we launched my YouTube channel, which I just started off like posting home videos of me on my piano singing. And then we got, you know, like we redid it and we relaunched it. And I started doing original music. I started writing. And I just love writing so much because, and doing original music, because now we're not doing covers anymore. We're doing all original music, which is what I've wanted to do forever and, you know, what I've seen myself doing. And it's great because I get to show people and like what I'm feeling and who I am, and people can see it better than as if I was just singing somebody else's song, you know? So it's amazing.
You know, what's so funny is I read last night that the first cover that you ever did was Maybe from Annie.
Yeah, it was.
And literally, it's been stuck in my head since last night. I can't stop singing it like so obnoxiously in my head. It's horrible.
Yeah, it's really funny too that I picked that song out of all the songs because I do not sing musical theater at all. I'm like the completely different direction. So,
so funny. So your debut studio album is dropping September 25th.
Yes.
This Is Me.
Yeah, it's out for pre-order now. So.
Awesome. Yeah. So you got to work with some of the top producers that have worked with Mariah Carey, Nicki Minaj, Justin Bieber. So what was that like for you? And, you know, how involved were you in the creative process with them?
It's just so awesome that I get to, you know, I've only been doing this for like 3 years, and just to see how fast things can happen if you really work hard and, you know, put yourself and surround yourself with the right people. And, you know, it was so amazing being able to work with people who I've been, like, aspiring to, like, work with and, like, who inspire me to become a better artist. And it's so, like, I'm so influenced by, like, the way that they work and how professional they are and how great their products are in the end. And it was just amazing. And I got there and I was like, oh my God, this is happening. Like, I'm working with this person who I've been, like, wanting to work with forever, who's, like, the dream producer. And it's really cool.
So what's your favorite song off the album?
That's really hard because they're all so different, if you can think about it, because, you know, that's why I called it This Is Me, because I don't feel like I'm put into a box. I'm doing what speaks to me. But that's really hard. My favorites often change, though, too, like, on my mood and, like, depending on, like, which one we're pushing. Like, right now, Crazy Beautiful, which is the one I performed at the Today Show, is, like, my favorite because I've been listening to that one and, like, practicing that with my band, like, over and over again. So, but I also really like Bring Me to Life, which I did with Kaylin and Miles, who are on the track, and they're amazing. And then there's also this one called Not Afraid of Love, which I did with Rock Mafia. And then Bring Me to Life I did with Red One. So
when you go into the studio or you go in to write, what kind of, take us through your process. What do you do when you sit down to start writing or producing a song?
Well, it often changes. Like, sometimes I'll start with my piano, and since those are my roots, and start ground up, like, from, you know, chord progressions and melody and lyrics, and, you know, do it completely on my own and then leave it like that. Or sometimes I will take it to an engineer producer and say, this needs to be bigger, but here's, like, the bass, and then we'll go up from that. Other times we'll have producers send in tracks and then I'll really like it and write to that. And other times we'll just, like, be in the studio together. We'll just, like, throw random ideas at each other. So it just really depends on, like, who you're with and their style, how they work, yeah.
So who would you say that your top influences were musically on this album?
Well, my favorite artist is, like, Beyonce, because she's awesome. but really, this album, it really didn't have, like, an influence, because it really is me. And like I said, that is why I called it This Is Me, because it's 100% me. And I had an EP earlier in January, and I always say, like, that's what I felt like was, like, the introductory to, like, Skylar and the original music that I'm going to be doing forever. And I feel like this is, like, the full package. Like, it's done, and, like, we just got the hard copies today, some of them, and it was, like, incredible just to look at it and be like, oh my God, this is really happening.
I think it's so fitting that you did call your album This Is Me, because I feel like just from listening to the few tracks that I've been able to hear, I really feel your personality shine through, and I really feel like you're so, you know who you are, and you know what you want to sing about, and you know what you want to write about, and I think that's so incredible.
And a lot of people also think, since I am 13 and I'm so young, that, you know, like, people are telling me what kind of music to sing and sing this song and, you know, do this, and it's not the case at all. I am 100%, you know, I have, like, everything is what I feel should be like this, and me and my personality and my take of everything, along with Trey Trienerscope, and who I just recently signed with as well, and they're amazing. But, you know, this is me, you know, it really is. It's not somebody else who's trying to put it through me and say this is me, because it's not.
You are so comfortable in your own skin. What do you owe that to? For being 13, that's incredible.
I feel like also because I am in the industry and I'm surrounding myself with older people and people who are more mature. So I feel like who you surround yourself with, you are like a sponge and you kind of, like, you know, absorb their energy and the way they go about things. So I feel like definitely being in the industry and around those kind of people have helped me, you know, become more mature and, you know, like, have more knowledge, or, you know, being in the business and stuff. So
it's great that, I mean, you have such a hand in what you do, and that at Cherry Tree they're letting you do that. And I read that you're the youngest person signed to their label.
Yes, I am, which is crazy.
That's crazy. Do you think that that is something that's more intimidating, or does it push you to want to be that much better and kind of prove yourself and say, yeah, I might be young, but I rock?
Well, it's amazing that I have found a team so young that I know believes in me and, you know, thinks that I have all this potential that me and my family and everyone around us knows that, you know, what could happen. And it's so great just to have the feeling, like a comforting feeling of just knowing that these people are going to have your back forever. And, you know, they're just amazing. And yeah, I definitely feel like, I don't feel like intimidated, because I definitely feel like I am more mature than most 13-year-olds. So I feel just like, this is awesome. Let's do this thing. And this is amazing.
You really feel like you're 25. Like, talking to you, you're just so mature.
I kind of do, but
you're so
certain
mature.
Things, no, though, because my mom's like, whoa, whoa, slow down, Skylar. Like, you're still 13. But it's a happy medium.
So kind of taking that on the other end, what do you think the hardest part about being a kid, being 13 in this industry has been for you?
For me, it hasn't really been hard, because this is what I want to do, and you know, I love this, and this doesn't feel like a job to me at all, because this is my passion and my dream and what I've wanted to do since forever. And you know, it's amazing that I'm living my dream every single day. Nothing's really been hard. It's just been amazing, because this is what I pictured myself doing, and I just started homeschooling. Like, this is my second year. Or third, I don't remember, but but it's just amazing to see, like, this is what I planned for myself. So instead of like playing sports and being like, oh, this is so hard and I don't get a childhood, I already feel like I'm mature and like you said, like 25 years old. So I already feel like I'm like living this life of like an adult. So it's awesome.
So how do you stay in touch with your friends and kind of keep in the kid kind of lifestyle?
Yeah, well, in this like environment, and like when I'm doing singing and anything business-like, I am more mature. But trust me, if you ask anyone in my team or my mom or anyone, like, I am still behind the scenes a 13-year-old girl. And
as you should be.
As I should be, yeah. You know, and there's a time and a place for certain things. So.
Right. So if your fans could take away one thing from listening to your music, listening to your album, what do you think you would want that one thing to be?
I want them to take away, you know, that, like I said earlier, I know I'm repeating myself, but this is me, you know? And, you know, and I want them to take away, wow, like, this girl is, like, being serious. She's not just doing this as, like, a hobby. This is really what she was going to do forever. And, you know, and compare me to everyone else who's older and, you know, has been doing it for a long period of time, because I picture myself up with those people, because just because I'm 13 doesn't mean I'm, you know, lower or anything. And I want them also just to know that this is me and this is who I am.
So if you could work with anyone and have anyone kind of be your mentor, I think I know who you're going to say, but who would it be?
Do you want to say another count of three?
Yeah. One, two, three.
Beyonce. Yes, she got it.
And I feel like that should be anyone's answer, because queen.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she's awesome.
So is there a tour or anything in your near future? Can we see you on the road?
I hope so. Right now, we're just getting ready for the album release. But I would love to go on a tour and do some more solo shows. I actually just did a performance at Mall of America like this week, and it was awesome too. And it was my first performance track show, because usually I have a band. But I would love to do more shows in the future, and I know there will definitely be some. So.
And where do you think you see yourself in 5 years?
Ooh, in 5 years? That's hard. Well, I see myself, you know, breaking records and, you know, being one of the greats and, you know, staying true to myself always through the whole entire journey and having songs on the charts and breaking records. Actually, Rooftop, my first single, got up to number 11 on the Billboard dance charts, and it was so close to number 10. It was so close, but...
Well, 11 is pretty good for, you know, your first try.
Yeah, exactly. And it just shows that, you know, how it, you know, if you really work hard and work towards something and believe in yourself and go for it, things can happen. And it's amazing.
So do you think you see yourself kind of using your platform or branching out from music and acting to do something else in the future? And I mean, to add it onto your plate, or do you want to just focus on
music? Well, definitely right now, music is my number one priority. I love acting too, but acting's more of a thing where if I really, really, really like a role, then I really want to go on the audition. But I'm not like, here's a role, just go on it, just to go on it. Because, you know, I have to really be passionate about something to really want it. But yeah, music is definitely my number one priority. But it'd be amazing to explore other options in the future. That'd be great. Yeah.
Speaking of passion, I read that you love animals, that you're a vegan.
I am a vegan. I love animals.
So tell us a little bit about that.
Oh, sorry.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I've been a vegan since January, but I've been a vegetarian for 5 years. Five or six years. I actually started when I saw this like chicken truck like passing by on the highway in Wisconsin, and my heart just broke because these chickens were like in the cages, like with their heads hanging out, and it was just so gruesome and so sad. And I was like, I'm gonna become a vegetarian. Like, I'm not gonna do this to animals anymore. And I'm going to really commit. And my mom, who was already at the time a vegetarian, she's been one since she was 13, my age. And she was like, okay, I support you. But she like didn't really know if I was going to commit all the way or not. And I did. And it's funny because then I became a vegan. But it's funny because my brother, who's 7, he was eating beef jerky one day. And he was like, yum, this is so great. And he's like, what is this made out of anyways? And then my dad or my mom was like, oh, that's cow. And he's like, no, it's not. And my mom was like, yeah, it is. And he was like, I'm not going to eat meat anymore. And we were like, yeah, right, Dorset, okay. And he hasn't since. And it's been like a year since he has. And like, we're all like, oh my God.
He's 7?
He's 7 years old.
That's crazy.
And he's like super athletic. Like, he wants to play football when he's older, like hardcore. So my dad's like, oh, brother, like.
Good luck with that. No, I'm just kidding. Well, okay. I think that we will throw it to the audience for some questions.
Yeah. No way.
Hey, how's it going?
Going good. How are you?
Congratulations on your career. Sounds like it's launching. It's going to be
awesome.
Thank you. Have you thought about, since signing with Interscope, any collaboration with Zed in the future?
You know, that was tossed in the air, and, you know, his people, where we were talking to his people, and we had actually a song that I recorded for the album, but it never, like, fully got finished. So, yeah, but hopefully for the next album, we do something even better, and that will make it. So, yeah.
Hi, I'm Leslie. I just want to know, what songs do you choose to cover?
I usually like choose when I used to cover songs, like songs that were popular, songs that I really felt I could do something different and unique with, instead of like sticking to it straight. But in the past, I did a cover to like Chandelier from Sia. And then Pretty Hurts, which was playing earlier. And I was like, oh my God, I sound so little because it was like so long ago. Human by Christina Perry, and tons more. Yeah.
Hi. How involved were you in the writing of the lyrics for the new album?
For my EP, there were 7 songs on them. I wrote 5 out of the 7 completely lyrically and melody by myself, and then the other ones I co-wrote. So for this album, though, I probably like co-wrote 95%, and then there's like one song, Crazy Beautiful, which was thrown in last minute, and they're like, oh, this song's awesome, we have to record this. And we were like already done with the album, like we got our track listing, we got everything done, and then I went and recorded it, and everyone was like, oh, this is awesome, and we have to have it on the album. So that was like the only one, though. I think maybe there's like one more, but I think that was like the only one that was like already written and like ready to go.
How long on average do you think it takes you to write a song?
Well, the fastest I've ever written a song was in less than 24 hours. We were rushing because we had all this stuff during the week, and we were like, oh my gosh, we have a recording session tomorrow. Like, I need to write this song. And I sat down at the computer, probably wrote it in like about 6 hours, not straight, like getting up and down. But yeah, and it's called Hey, and it was actually one of the singles that was on my EP. And so yeah.
Do you prefer to write with someone else, or do you prefer to write kind of alone in your own head?
I mean, I'm fine with writing with other people, but I feel like when I'm on my own, I become like very like serious, and like my mom will be like, I have an idea. I'm like, no, shh, I'm focused. But it's not like I'm trying to be mean. It's just like I'm like so focused in my craft. And then with other people, it's great too, because you're able to like see how they do it and to have more experience with working with other people. But I feel like I have more of like a say in everything and more control when I'm writing it by myself rather than somebody else's ideas and opinions. But I like them both. But if I had to choose, I'd prefer writing by myself.
Hi there. Have you thought about your future plans, like for school, maybe college? If so, what you'd want to study?
You know, I, well, I'm 13, so I haven't really thought about that far into into it. But yeah, like I said, I am homeschooled right now. And my program before was getting like really hard because it was all on like a laptop and like computer. So when we'd run to places, if there wasn't Wi-Fi, I couldn't do work and I was getting behind. So now we're switching to like a program where it's all workbook based. And I'm actually really excited to start again. I start on like in like 5 days. So yeah.
Okay, well, I think we're going to wrap it up.
Awesome.
Thank you so much,
thank you,
Skylar.
Thank you.
And your album, her album drops September 25th, so everybody should totally get it.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.